In our last episode, Cecil B. DeMille and the preview audience of the Squaw Man discovered a technical problem. The image was crawling up the screen. Jesse Lasky had made cash sales to every state in the Union. Sam Goldwyn was publicizing the upcoming release and had scheduled a preview screening 3 weeks away. Cecil had to solve this problem or lose everything. Cecil and his editor, Mamie Wagner, lay the affected portions of the film on a table next to some ordinary film. The sprocket holes were spaced differently. To save time and money, Cecil had bought unperforated film stock, and then he had perforated each day's stock himself. Mamie said, "You bought the wrong perforator. Look, this perforator does 65 frames per foot. The printer sees 64. But how do we fix it?" Sam and Jesse took the negative to North Philadelphia. Sigmund Lubin was a prosperous studio owner. Sam and Jesse had to look for him in his large plant. His nickname was Pop Lubin. He welcomed Sam and Jesse. He looked at the reel of film and then took it to his editing room. He was there for a long time, but when he emerged, there was good news. His editor could glue blank film on the edge of the negative and then punch new sprocket holes. Jesse and Sam did a victory dance on the sidewalk outside Lubin's studio. The Squaw Man had been saved. The press screening took place at the theater where the Lasky Company had its offices. The audience included DeMille's brother William, a successful playwright, and DeMille's mother Beatrice. William DeMille thought a respected theatrical family should have nothing to do with the Flickers. The Longacre Theater was not equipped for films, so the Squaw Man was presented in a ballroom. What did the audience see? A lonely outcast nobleman, a Native American who had killed to save his life, two people at a cultural crossroads. An unconventional love story with a tragic ending. Cecil's brother wasn't the only positive review. The instant and overwhelming success of The Squaw Man was not lost on Sam Goldwyn or Jesse Lasky, who came from New York to see just how Cecil had created something from nothing and had bought the studio. Cecil was making feature films in the new film center, Hollywood. Sam and Jesse wasted no time in getting Cecil money for his next film. And for his next film. Cecil was having too much success and too much fun not to attract attention. W.W. Hodgkinson was planning a distribution chain. No more states' rights to worry about. His company would finance and distribute 104 films a year. Adolph Zucker and Hobart Bosworth had already signed with Hodgkinson, also the great David Belasco. Hodgkinson had seen The Squaw Man come out of nowhere. He knew what Sam and Jesse were planning for Cecil. Cecil was creating a repertory and a team. He'd been cheated by David Belasco years earlier. Did Cecil need Paramount? Another decision had to be made.